Welcome back again. So there's the scene at Croke Park, and here come the men from Clare for the first time since 1970. Yes, they've waited for such a long time for this moment. 75 years it's been coming, and so Clare are into their first All-Ireland football semi-final in modern times. But what happens this year, whatever happens this year, there's going to be a new pairing in that All-Ireland final. Johnny Gall, of course, already through for their first appearance. But let's not forget as well that for Dublin, this is also a very big day. They haven't won the All-Ireland since 1983. Their supporters down here on Hill 16 are looking forward to another All-Ireland final appearance for their side. And there's a picture there that they've been waiting for a long, long time, down in Clare, to come and applaud and to admire. And Kevin Costner, famous film actor, is in the crowd here today. I don't know if he fully appreciates the significance of this. Perhaps he does. Of course, Kevin, in Ireland recently to make a film. Maybe he's become aware of the fame of this current Clare team. Well, it's a proud day for so many Clare people here who have come to support their team, and not least amongst them, our own big match commentator from the county of Clare himself. Let's say good afternoon to Marty Morrissey.
And a very good afternoon, Michael Lester, and certainly unbelievable scenes here in Croke Park. And as Michael says, they've been waiting 75 years, since 1917, to see a Clare team on Croke Park. And as you saw a moment ago, Kevin Costner, there's the Minister Brendan Daly from Cora Clare, and Cora Clare man, he's here as well, looking on anxiously and praying to the God that the day the sun will shine on the people of Clare. Well, we've had Kevin Costner already shown on the JFK. We've had the Pope, now 31 counties want a Clare victory. And this is the team, the 15 men that brought home the Munster title for the first time since 1917. Doubts about Kieran O'Mahony and a niggling back injury were cleared up during the week, and he takes his place at cornerback. Tom Morrissey and Aidan Maloney at midfield could swing the game if they can dominate, but the real test for Clare will be simple. Can the half-forward line of Noel Roach, Vance McInerney and Jerry Killeen keep the Dublin half-back line busy? There's the message to the from the Clare people to the Dublin supporters. Say goodbye to the Hill, Sam. You're on your way. As this man, they call him God down in County Clare, from Crossmolina in County Mayo, Clare manager John Mohan. What a transformation he's brought about in a very short space of time. Noel Roach just going out of picture, 15 years on the Clare team, and absolutely looking forward to this day. Dublin bid for a place in the All-Ireland final, a place they haven't been since 1985. Unchanged from the Leinster final, Dave Bourne and Paul Clark are combined again in midfield, while the attack will be hoping for a better return from players like Jack Sheedy and Niall Guyton. Again, the Dublin side will be depending on that formidable halfback line of Paul Curran, Keith Barr and Eamon Hearing. I'm talking from John Mohan. So too to the Dubs. We're getting a last minute chat from Tommy Clare as Inapol TD from County Clare, Cilla De Valera, is here to witness the historic occasion. The men from Clare put their arms around each other and have been doing that for the last year and a half under John Mohan. Today they face their greatest test. Nico Noir, Kildare manager, is here. Keep an eye out with John Glenn, the manager of the Burlington Hotel. They're coming from near and far as the people here in Croke Park stand for our long living.
James Hanahan, Ed Maloney, Candy
gather it. Falls out towards Big Bar. Well done by Vinnie Murphy. That's another good score by Dublin. And Dublin are looking very impressive in the opening 3 minutes of play.
Role in this Clare team cannot be underlined enough. His
very much the dominant influence. The players very much look up to him. James Hanahan, the Durham Airfield Club, plays junior football in the county of Clare. Now playing in an All-Ireland semi-final.
Sends the pass of the party Conway and he gets an easy point.
Paul Curran says he was innocent. Referee Tommy McDermott says he wasn't, and it's a free for Clare. Croke Park, packed to capacity. Seating and tickets at a premium that were virtually impossible to get. And as Clare people travelled to Dublin this morning, all along the roads, whether you came the Athlone route, the Limerick Nina route, there was good luck to Clare. Martin Flynn having a lash but sending it wide. John Mahan has been concerned, Colm, in the past that the Clare team were a little bit slow to settle.
Yes, but the last 5 minutes now they've got very much into the game. I think due mainly to Tom Morrissey at midfield, who's going up with a huge height for these kickouts.
Knocked away by Paul Clark. Comes down to Niall Guy, Frankie Griffin right beside him. Dave Bourne calling from the middle. Knocked away by Tom Morrissey for the break pass to Niall Guy. Getting it inside to Jack Sheedy. Good scoring position on here. And he sends it to the right and wide. And that is a bad miss by Jack Sheedy. That should have been put over.
Relatively easy chance for Jack Sheedy, especially after the area one would have expected him to convert that. But it's not particularly easy to kick the ball when you're running directly straight for the goals. Most forwards would like to be turned at right angles, and Jack Sheedy showed there that it's more difficult running fast and straight at the goal.
Knocked away. Tactic by Dublin. Knocking down to their weak forwards and corner forwards. Dizzy Farrell to Vinnie Murphy. Vinnie inside. Oh, what a marvellous goal! Vinnie Murphy, a peach of a goal that sends his 16 alive. That's the kind of goal that you're going to get in any match.
Brilliant goal there by Vinnie Murphy. A lot of the play work by Dizzy Farrell, who doesn't seem fully fit with that leg injury, gives it in. Gerry Kelly is beaten to the catch. Vinnie Murphy hammers him to the roof of the net. I don't think that James Hanahan had any chance.
A real test of Clare's character as they find themselves trailing now by 6 points to two, 1-3 to two. Tommy Carr to take the sideline kick. Frankie Griffin picking up the break. Giving it to Ian Maloney. Popping it twice illegally. And the referee spotted it as well. Gives the free to Dublin. That goal is a tremendous boost to the Leinster champions, Colin.
Absolutely. Every team needs a few scores early on in the game. Dublin have got the ideal start, getting the goal in 3 points. All of them well worked. I think that was a harsh enough decision against Ian Maloney. I think he controlled the ball by hopping it, but he wouldn't technically be in possession at that stage.
Charlie Redmond with his second attempt. That's the angle he faces. 1 point already attributed to Charlie Redmond. But that one very much tailing to the left and wide. 12 and a half minutes gone in the first half. And a marvellous goal by Vinnie Murphy. Charlie Redmond a little bit disappointed with that last effort.
Just a very slight autumn breeze. Kick
finds Paul Clark. Again, trying to find Billy Murphy. The Clare underneath it, and Jota Ryan gets his break. Ian Maloney telling James Hanrahan to come out and take it. It's interesting to see that Clare have moved Ian Maloney in to fullback. Jerry Kelly is now at midfield.
Yes, Ian Maloney, who would be probably a better defender than a midfielder. And Billy Murphy was causing a lot of problems here for Jerry Kelly. And I think that's a good move by Clare.
Tom Morrissey getting into the hang of breaking the ball. This time giving it to Noel Roach. And it's Frankie that's going to drop it in. Testing ball for John O'Leary. And Paul Conway, but the referee has given the free. He's given the free out to Dublin. A call disallowed at one end. Conway going in at John O'Leary. An interesting decision by the referee. Tom Morrissey gets the frame. These Clare lads will go through a wall at the moment. We hardly hear the referee's whistle.
The first chance that Dublin got the ball off was a fairly clear cut free out. But in this case, Pádraig Conway gets his hand to the ball and puts it in the back of the net. As far as I'm concerned, he hit the ball in, and I don't think that goal should have been disallowed.
Frankie Griffin sending it in towards Francis McInerney. Jerry Killeen was pushed by Paul Curry, so it's a free for Clare. Clare now taking their 10th free of this first half. Jerry Killeen bring it down to just 3 points if he can put this one over. Yeah. And he puts it over the bar. John O'Leary taps it over, and suddenly Clare are back in this match once again. They've survived the initial test so far.
Want to get his freeze well over the bar, because John O'Leary will stay at anything that's a couple of foot over, so he wants to get the ball right, probably 5 or 6 feet over the bar.
Fine kick out by John O'Leary, comes down to nine by Keith Barr, coming forward once again. Frankie Griffin trying to keep him back. Barr, a goal in the Leinster final, and not a point on this occasion, just to the right and wide, but he loves to come forward. And Clare will very much have to keep him back in his own half of the field.
Yes, it's impossible now to keep Barr back. Francis McInerney, of course, has been a centre forward. And all the Dublin half-backs will get forward at some time. It's just impossible to stop them. But Keith Barr will be disappointed. He probably would have felt he should have cut that one over the bar.
Again, the break. Now Guy getting it in quickly. Aidan Maloney started off his career with the Murray Ulbricken at full-back. Drives that one wildly. Terry Killeen unable to keep it in. Sideline ball, Paul Curran ready to take it. Vinnie Murphy calling for it at the edge of the square. And that's exactly where Paul Curran is aiming it for. Vinnie Murphy has it! And just getting it out. It's a free out, in fact. The referee has blown his whistle. I think he claimed that Aidan Maloney was being pushed. But anxious moments, and certainly even in this 21 minutes gone in the first half, Colin. Careful backline are under a lot of pressure when the high ball goes in from Dublin.
Yes, Dublin, as they have been doing all year, getting that ball in fast to the full power line. And Vinnie Murphy has been winning a lot of possession and either scoring himself or laying off. But Dublin have a significant advantage of the breeze, and Clare have done well to hold them, because Dublin opened really devastating form, but Clare have come back into it very well.
Again, the feeling and the break goes to Dublin. Eamon Heary taking too many steps with the ball, and it's a free to Clare. ...22 minutes gone in this first half. That Vinnie Murphy goal separating the sides. Jerry Kelly plays his club football at centre half back for Kilkee. Now playing in midfield for Clare, loves to come forward. It's a great effort by Kelly. John O'Leary under pressure, fists it out towards Jack Sheedy, the right half forward, deep inside his own territory. It's a long ball, way down the field. Charlie Redmond's leaving it for Billy Murphy. Aidan Maloney with him, puts him out over the line. It's going to be a line ball for Clare. The Quilty man going back to his more familiar position at fullback when he was a young lad. Paul Byrne gets a hand to it. That's an unfair challenge by Jack Sheedy. Ball quickly inside towards Martin Flynn. From Milton Malbec. Giving it back outside to Corey Conway. He's switching from one corner to another. Still Corey Conway. Taking too many steps, however, with the ball. And it's a free out for Dublin. Over anxiety slightly on that occasion.
Yes, Corey Conway definitely took the many steps. It was a good decision by the referee. Dublin, or the Clare forwards, seem intent on taking on their men on every occasion, so I suppose there are times when they're probably going to overplay the ball as well.
Paul Kern taking the free. Jesse Farrell coming out to gather it. Looking for a loose Clare. Jack Sheedy is the man. Has a goal from way out the field, but it's tailing to the right and wide. Still the scoreline remains the same. Dublin 1-4, Clare 4 points, 24 minutes gone in the first half. Anxious faces in the crowd. It's a tense atmosphere here at Croke Park. As James Hanrahan takes yet another kick out. Well gathered by Tom Morrison. This time Dave Burns' tactic of trying to break down the ball didn't work for a Clare man. One of 13 children gets the ball and gives it to his Frankie Griffin.
Tom Morrissey has not been over on any occasion anyway. He's having a great game in the middle of the field for Clare, winning a lot of very good possession.
Long ball up, knocked away. Frank Speckinelli can't hold out to it. Runs nicely back to Tom Morrissey again. He's playing well. He was only 5'5" at 17. At 22, he was 6'3". And they put it down in Cora Clare to Goldsmith. Add in a few Cora Clare spots when you have a man like Tom Morrissey. Jerry Kelly with this free. Paul Curran standing in front of it. To reduce Dublin's lead to 2 points. It's tailing to the left, kept in by Martin Flynn. Keith Barr, under pressure, gets the free. Martin Flynn getting quickly into his position at cornerback, corner forward rather, watching McDeegan for the quick free.
Sort of free that Clare would need to be getting. I suppose Charlie Redmond would probably be a better free taker than Jerry Killeen, and Dublin have a bit of an advantage in that area.
Tom Morrissey again getting his foot to it, comes down to Eamon Heering. Again the long ball, trying to find Billy Murphy, and he gathers it outside to Mick Galvin. This is good play. Paul Clark, Seamus Clancy comes in to challenge, but Paul Clark gets his second point of the afternoon. Good score by the Whitehall, Colin Gillsman, coming forward into the attack to act as an extra man.
Again, Billy Murphy with the target, winning possession and laying it off very well. Paul Clark coming forward there. He's losing his man a couple of occasions coming forward. Clare midfield will have to be far more vigilant in watching him.
Colin Clancy giving it back to Noel Roach. Just took his eye off it for a moment. Still Noel Roach has it. Gets it back outside, but referee says that the challenge was illegal by Paul Curran. I must say the challenge looked fair enough, but it gives the advantage to Jerry Killeen to reduce down the lead to 3 points once again. Prison officer from Limerick dropping it in and dropping it to the left and wide. And that's the sort of a miss that Clare do not want.
Absolutely, but I'm surprised at the rest. standing so close to those trees. They're certainly not 14 yards away. And it really cut them very clean off.
7 minutes to the half-time whistle. Dublin still leading. Spence McInerney, hit by Martin Finn. Good anticipation by McDeegan. Loves to come forward, the cornerback, to Paul Clark. Again, they search out for Vinnie Murphy. He's knocked away, it comes to Niall Guy. Referee gives the free. Back to Vinnie Murphy, but the referee says no. He's given the free to Charlie Redmond once again. And it gives Dublin further opportunity to stretch their lead.
Center half hour. The Francis McInerney has begun to win a lot of
Charlie Redmond from Dublin that sends it up a good ball to Jack Sheedy. Outside of his Paul Byrne. Great attacking halfback. Dropping it in. Oh, that's a superb point. A great point by Paul Byrne. A lovely footballer from Tala. And that restores Dublin's lead once again. 4 points between the sides. 1-7-6. 2 minutes to half time.
Very good play from Charlie Redmond there in particular to set up that chance for Paul Horton. Two shows you can't allow him to get forward. JJ Rank, who was able to get in the tackle. But it was a very difficult angle for a point and a very good score by Paul Farrell or Paul Horton.
This is Tom Morrissey sending a ball into space with Deegan and Martin Flynn. Deegan getting there first. Sending it back up the middle. Frank McInerney is underneath it. It gathers it despite the challenge from Jack Sheedy. Frankie Griffith with Kilrush coming outside, showing a little bit too much of it. And a high boot there by Niall Garden on Martin Flynn. And Flynn doesn't like the challenge at all. And it's unusual for Martin Flynn to retaliate in any way, but he was angered by that high boot by Niall Garden. The Rahini man is booked by the referee. Jojo Roy is coming up to take it, the centre half-back. Clare and Dublin people a little bit anxious. Jojo Roy, the army man from the FCA camp in Lahinch, glides it beautifully over the bar. The people of Rennes, the people of Clare, salute Jojo Roy. They'll go mad in Roy if they win this one tonight. Clare, now trailing by 3 points once again.
Very dangerous tackle by Niall Guyton to give away that free, but be very much out of character for Niall Guyton. Wouldn't be a dirty player by any means.
Tom Morrissey knocking it down as the ball breaks free. The referee blows the half-time whistle. And a scene here at Croke Park that is unbelievable, really. Tremendous atmosphere. Tom Morrissey congratulates Jerry Kelly. The Banner County are still in it. They trail at half time to Dublin's 1-7, Clare's 7 points. As you join us, the second half has started and Clare have a point on the scoreboard. Martin Daly, a substitute who came on at half-time for Kieran O'Neill, as Clare make alterations in their team. Jerry Kelly, centre half-back. Jojo Roy, left half-back. As Clare go forward. Dave Horn with the kick-out, gathering the kick-out. Jerry Killeen for Clare is now playing at centre-half forward. And Aidan Maloney is still at full-back on Vinnie Murphy as Dublin go into the attack. Desi Farrell knocking it away by Kieran O'Mahony. It's a line ball for Dublin. 2 points between the sides. Jack Sheedy again. Aiming at Vinnie Murphy. Comes back outside to Niall Garden, and that's a good score for Dublin. An easy one. Slack marking by the Clare defence. But a well taken point by the Rahini man.
Again, the long ball into the Clare defence causing problems. Frankie Griffin lying far too far off Niall Garden and giving him an easy chance.
On all the way towards Martin Flynn. Sending the ball in towards the middle. Philip Clancy, knocked away by Jerry Hardman. The same in Healy, bursting his way forward. Hard to a very fine half-back line. Desi Farr being fouled by Kieran O'Mahony. Another free for Dublin. Interesting switches by Clare at half-time, Colin.
I think the changes are good insofar as Derry Kelly gets under half and change to Ruan should help to strengthen up the defence. Jack Sheehy was getting a lot of room on that right wing for Dublin the first half, and even though he missed a couple of chances for points, he was causing a lot of trouble. He was delivering the ball into Vinnie Murphy.
So Charlie Redmond, 5 points against Kildare in the Leinster final. Going for a second in an All-Ireland semi-final. He hits it well, but he hits it to the right of the post, much to the delight of the Clare crowd. James Hanrahan with the kick out. All of them for consistently high standard, right out towards Tom Morrissey. Easy ball given away to Paul Clark. Jojo Ruan anticipating well, sending it back down. Keith Barr underneath it. As Dublin launch another attack. Jack Sheedy switching it over to the far side. Paul Clark. Hot pursuit. Challenged by Noel Roach. Right. Still Dublin build it up slowly. And eventually run out of steam. It's a free to Clare. That foul on Aidan Maloney. Driving it long down to his Corey Conway. Tommy Carr. Conway gathering the break. And getting the free. Martin Daly. The hero from Lissy Casey that scored a goal in the Munster final, going for his second point. It's curling, but is it curling enough? It's not. Scoreline remains the same. Dublin 1-8, Clare 8 points. John O'Leary with the kick out. To McInerney again, back to Flynn, playing it a little bit too tight. Francis driving it in, sending it over the crossbar. Clare are now just 2 points behind. The no-hopers from the Banner County are putting up an admirable performance. 1-8 to 9.
Great point by Francis McInerney. Seemed to have overplayed the ball and then got himself in trouble. Dublin in big trouble around the middle of the field, and now into Jason Paul Balin. Tom Morrissey has been dominating there for the whole of the first half, so it's not unusual to see a substitute coming on there.
Paul Balin introduced to the Dublin team. Dave Ford is taken off as John O'Leary takes the kick out. The break falls to Paul Clark. Two Clare players still on the deck. Charlie Redmond going through. Forced his way forward, good position and a good point by Charlie Redmond. A very fine score for Dublin, and it puts those 3 points again between the teams. Tom Morrissey is the man that's down injured. John Mahon meanwhile is having a word with Jerry Kelly as Tom Morrissey is down injured. And if he has to go off, Clare's hopes will certainly take a nosedive. Seems to be a leg injury, obviously, there.
Tom Morrissey there, a bit too brave for his own good, coming across in midfield for a ball that wasn't really his, and when it breaks down to Paul Carr, Charlie Redmond up in support, and Charlie at that sort of angle keeps going forward straight for the goals and keeps a very good point on the run.
Tom is back on his feet, much to the delight of the Clare people. James Hanrahan aiming to find this man. Referee telling him to hurry it up. Drives it right down the middle. Runs all the way back to Keith Barr. Outside to Paul Curran. Dublin coming forward in numbers. Martin Daly in hot pursuit. Sending a ball. Not a great one for Vinnie Murphy. And he can't reach it. So it's a kick out for James Hanrahan. That's the 12th wide of the match for Dublin.
Bad use of possession by Paul Curran there. A very good chance to cross that ball over to the middle to a couple of the Dublin forwards, Nick Gallagher and Vinnie Murphy, and I think he was trying for a point himself, but he was a bit optimistic at that range.
The referee just having a word with his linesman. Obviously, the linesman just telling the referee to be aware of what's going on off the ball. Paul Beelan getting his first touch, manages to get it past Charlie Redmond. Charlie trying a lash at the point, but he sends it wide. Seven wides for Dublin. And they still lead by Vinnie Murphy's goal. Almost 9 minutes gone in the second half.
Thank you.
Clancy back in with McGalvin. Getting inside McGalvin, but the referee had blown his whistle, and it's a free in for Dublin. And I still haven't seen who's gone off the Clare team, to be honest with you. And at the moment, I have a sneaky suspicion that Clare could be playing with 16 men. The linesman at the far side is waving his flag, and John Mahon is trying to get a word so he can take off the man that Michael Rowan came on for. And it now looks Jerry Kelly has been called in by John Mahon. And Jerry Kelly, in fact, is the man that's been taken off. So Jerry Kelly is off, Michael Rowan is in.
It just shows the difficulty in trying to communicate from the line on occasion like that, with the noise at its height as it is here at Croke Park. John Mahon just couldn't get a message in to Jerry Kelly to come off. Has happened to quite a few teams this year, and a lot of teams have got fined as a result of managers cursing on the pitch, but it's difficult to get a message into a player without them coming in.
Charlie Redmond with the spray. Put 5 points between the sides. That's exactly what he does. 1-11 for Dublin, 9 points for Clare. And Dublin have certainly picked up the pace, aided and abetted by some simple mistakes by Clare.
Dublin enjoying a clear period of dominance here, and Clare need to get back in the game quickly or else they'll be too far behind.
Noel Roach going back to Gallagher, sending it forward with Paul Byrne and Mark Daly. Tommy Carr picking up the wing. Dublin seems to have that edge in relation to the breaking ball. Just able to anticipate that a little bit better. Eamon Healy and Tommy Carr. Jerry Killeen. He fouled unquestionably by the big man. And Tommy Carr puts down the ball as Jerry Killeen is booked by the referee.
Bad foul by Jerry Killeen there, and Conor McDermott is absolutely no option but to group him. Tommy Carr breaking away from the quick free. Clare forwards getting caught watching, and it's very, very high tackle by Jerry Killeen.
Free quickly taken. Noel Roach trying to get there ahead of Kyle Guyton. It's a free in for Dublin. Moment very much suffering from a lack of shape. Only three forwards inside the Dublin half of the field at the moment, as Keith Barr outside the Clare 45 takes this free dangerously in, calls for Despard back to Jack Sheedy, takes his points splendidly. A good score by Jack Sheedy, and it puts that little bit of daylight between the Leinster and Munster champions.
Great point by Jack Sheedy, whipping it up and over the bar from the right hand side. Not the easiest place to score from him, for a player especially lacking in the confidence as he must be. Very good score there by Jack Sheedy, and for a player who probably felt that maybe his position was in jeopardy, he's done very well.
The other end is Clare in the attack, put out this time by Eamon Healy. Tom Morrissey is all alone in the middle of the field. Jerry Killeen is providing a man available to his right. It's quickly taken to Martin Flynn. Clare need a score here. Flynn from Milton Malvey puts it over the bar. It's down to 5 points once again. 1-12 for Dublin, 10 points for Clare. Good ball back into Dublin challenge by the Lizzie Casey man. It's going to be a free for Dublin. And Dublin very anxious to cool matters down. They have the advantage and the cushion of a 5-point lead. Mikey Griffin anticipating well, sending it back up towards Martin Flynn and Mick Deegan. Great balls for Jerry Kinney. Back to his right is Corey Conway. And Conway has it. To his left is Colin Clancy. Can he get the right foot to it? He's looking for a penalty and he's got it. He's got the penalty from Tommy McDermott. It looked as if Clancy sought the penalty. Paul Curran is questioning it. But Clare have a penalty. And this will bring them surely back into the match if and only if Jerry Killeen can score it. It's a battle between John O'Leary and Jerry Killeen. 5 points between the sides. But Jerry Killeen took a penalty in the Munster final. Kerry goalkeeper Peter O'Leary dived to his right and saved. This is unquestionably the most important kick in Jerry Killeen's life. It keeps Clare possibly in the All-Ireland semi-final. Dunbegman taking on O'Dwyer, saved, but he has it, it's there! The referee has blown his whistle and it's there! Jerry Killeen turned around and looked at the referee, but the goal stands and Clare are back in business. 2 points between the sides.
Dublin were in complete control of that game. Now they're going to be in trouble. A lot of players moved before the kick was taken. Jerry Killeen does well to follow up and finish it to the net, but I think it was a very questionable decision to give a penalty in the first instance.
A break cut brilliantly by Paul Clark. It's a free for Dublin. Keith Barr driving it in, and a goal for Dublin. The umpires have no problem whatsoever. A legitimate goal for Dublin, which puts Dublin back in the driving seat. An amazing turnaround in this game. Vinnie Murphy, the man who got a fist to it. And a lot of tension and a lot of aggravation now.
Again, Dublin doing same thing all day, getting the ball in high. Vinnie Murphy getting up there, getting his hand to it and ending up in the corner of the net. Good goal for Dublin. A quick reply to giving away the penalty and the goal on the other side.
Michael Rowan unable to pick it up. Seamus Clancy and Charlie Redmond battling it out. Redmond to get in there first. And eventually the referee gives the decision to the Leinster champions. Oh, what an amazing turnaround in this All-Ireland semi-final. Jerry Killeen scoring a goal on one end, Vinnie Murphy at the other. And just 20 and a half minutes gone in the second half. The 19th free for Dublin. Charlie Redmond to take it. From the dangerously in, Seamus Clancy is there. Being fouled by Vinnie Murphy. The referee wants it taken from where the foul was committed. George Ryan making himself available this side of the field. James Hanrahan going to drive it to the other side. Ball picked up nicely by Paul Beelan. He's played well since he came on in the second half. It's going to be another free, this time Keith Barr to take it. And again, they launch one of these missiles into the Clare half of the field. Well recovered by Aidan Maloney. And well cleared. Martin Daly and Paul Curran. Daly getting a fist to it. And it comes to Colin Clancy. Now can Clare do something here? Mick Deegan. Fine cornerback, leaving it for Keith Barr to Paul Curran. Here comes Dublin once more. Up towards Vinnie Murphy, Nate Maloney, puts his body in front of it to Tom Morrison.
Morrissey fouled in the beginning. Jack Sheedy does well. Good persistence by the Dublin forward line again. Three out there, it should have been Paul Phelan. Changed the ball from one hand to the other. Missed by the referee and finished at the net very well by Mick Gallagher.
Meanwhile, Mick Deegan coming forward. He's fouled and it's a free for the Leinster champions. Dublin's lead as we have 26 and a half minutes gone now in the second half. He hits it sweetly and puts it straight over the bar. Dublin 3-13, Clare 1-11. Can Clare come back or will the Metropolitans hold on? It's looking good for Dublin now. Frankie Griffin forcing his way forward. Looking for a little bit of support. Corey Conway now coming out to meet it. Tommy Carr trying to keep him at bay. Paul Clark now coming into challenge. The referee has given the free to Clare. Dropping it dangerously in. Comes to Colin Clancy. Scored a goal against Kerry, giving back to Terry Killeen, and that goes to the left and wide. And really, Banner County needs every opportunity to be available. Kerry, I reckon. Just doing a warm-up. And playing the forwards or in the backs.
Sides. A former magpie from Clare Castle.
to O'Brien is booked by referee Tommy McDermott. And St John's advocate then has indicated that he wants a stretcher from Charlie Redmond. Away. Dublin virtually certain now of being back here in Croke Park for the third Sunday in September. Michael Rowan knocking it down. Comes to Charlie Redmond, to Jesse Farrell. A point here just to make sure. That's exactly what he's got. Jesse Farrell ensures that it is a Dublin Denny goal all Ireland final.
Great point by Jesse Farrell off his right foot, which would be his weaker foot, running away from the goal and able to shade it in from right to left.
Gathering in Cullen, Pansmack and Ernie. Can Clare finish this match with a burst? It's a long ball up towards Corey Conway. John O'Leary watching it all the way, vigilant as ever. Charlie and Jojo. That's going to be a line ball for Clare. Charlie disagrees emphatically with the linesman. And in fact, the referee deems that it's going to be a hot ball there. Billy Murphy having to get the ball back. That's McInerney, unable to knock it down to a colleague. It's Paul Clark. Well, at midfield, right throughout this match, still got the acres of Croke Park in front of him. And then finishes off with a ball that slices off his foot. As they say, GAA parlance, it's as good as a score. James Hanrahan taking the kick out as the dump bench looks on. Dublin are through to the All Ireland final. And they congratulate Clare on their first performance at Croke Park since 1917. They scored 2 goals and 12 points. It was enough to win many matches, but not enough to beat the Dublin team. A fine, wonderful performance by Dublin. But Clare must be saluted. It was a daunting task to face into a packed Croke Park and produce a performance like today.
Well, I think Clare can go away with another credit from this match. They played very well. But Dublin were that bit slicker, a bit more experienced. and were overall were a better team on the day and deserved to win by 5 or 6 points probably.
Paul Clark being congratulated. John Mahon saying well done to Charlie Redmond. And knowing John Mahon, he will be bitterly disappointed that he lost this one. He has instilled a belief in this Clare side that you have to see to really appreciate it. As the Clare people celebrate a performance in Croke Park. The final score on All-Ireland semi-final day on Clare's first performance since 1917. That's the full-time score. Dublin, 3 goals and 14 points. Clare, 2 goals and 12.